Welcome to the 2014 Fall Commencement at Sol Ross State University. Please remain standing for the invocation led by Dr. Kathy Stein, Assistant Professor of English.
If you'll bow your heads with me. Creator of all that was, all that is, and all that will be, we thank you for the joy that fills this space today, and may we look for ways to bring joy to others. We thank you for all of the hard work that today's commencement represents, and may we take that same determination to our next set of goals and work just as hard to meet them. We thank you for the opportunities that these degrees will make possible for these graduates, and may we never take for granted the privilege that we have to obtain an education. May we always be learners. We thank you for all those who traveled here to be part of this celebration, and may our travels home be just as safe when we leave this building today. We thank you for this opportunity to celebrate these graduates, these families, and this institution. May we always have grateful hearts willing to celebrate that which is good and honest and true forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you, Kathy. Please remain standing and join in singing God Bless America, directed by Dr. Donald Freed. The words are printed on the back of your program. Please be seated. I would like to introduce some of our special guests in attendance this morning. Other members of the platform party will be introduced later. Seated on the platform are Ms. Anna Sandoval, student regent. Mr. James G. Worley, vice president for external affairs. Mr. Cesario Valenzuela, Vice President for Finance and Operations. Mr. Leo Dominguez, Dean of Student Life. Mr. Don Dowdy, Dean of Library and Information Technologies. Ms. Mary Beth Marks, Assistant Vice President for Enrollment Management. Mrs. Pam Pipes, Registrar. I would also like to recognize some very special guests who are seated on the floor. Would our very talented and accomplished faculty please stand? Thank you. And now it's my pleasure to introduce the 12th president of Sol Ross State University, Dr. Bill Kibler.
Good morning. We are so happy to see all of you here. You know, as I told, for those of you that are here with us this morning, as I told your students yesterday, this is what we're all here for. This is what we are so excited about. This is the time that really matters, because as we talk about the impact that Sol Ross State University has on the lives of our students, the impact that that has on this area, this region, this state, and this nation, It all comes down to today and the significance of your accomplishments on this day. Because all of us here at Solrock State University are committed to preparing our students to live a life, not just get a job. So I was honored to be asked to share some thoughts with you this morning as you enter the next chapter of your lives. So I want to talk just briefly about how we might make ourselves better. You know, I'm not an ethicist or a philosopher, so you won't hear that from me. As a matter of fact, in my opinion, the advice from that great philosopher, Yogi Berra, seems as good as any. When you come to a fork in the road, take it. I plan to be as brief as possible. You know, George Washington's second inaugural address was only 200 words. Abraham Lincoln's Gettysburg Address was 226 words. And the Ten Commandments is 297 words. By way of contrast, the United States Department of Agriculture's order on the price of cabbage is 15,689 words. So the message there is, unless you have more wisdom to share than Washington, Lincoln, or God, you need to be brief. I'd like to offer some personal comments to you as our graduates. In forming these thoughts, I've adapted and in some cases borrowed directly words from Anna Quindlen's small but very powerful book, A Short Guide to a Happy Life. Each of you are about to begin what some refer to as your real life. That could be a job. It could be a new job. Some of you have a job already. It could be graduate school or some other major change in your life or what you see as the pursuit of the rest of your life. I just wanted to make a comment or two about real life to you. Don't ever confuse the two. Don't ever confuse your life and your work. That's primarily what I have to say. The second is only part of the first. I'll never forget what a friend once wrote to Massachusetts Senator Paul Tsongas when the senator had decided to not run for re-election because he had been diagnosed with cancer. His friend said, "No man ever said on his deathbed, I wish I'd spent more time at the office." So it's also unlikely that your dying wish will be, "Bring me my Solrock diploma," or "Bring me my checking account statement," or "Bring me my new car." That's not likely to be what you wish for at that time. I also remember the words that I saw on a poster one time. If you win the rat race, you're still a rat. Or what John Lennon wrote before he was gunned down in the driveway of his own home. He said, "Life is what happens while you're busy making other plans." After all, when I look into your faces as the newest graduates of Solrock State University, I realize that each of you has only one thing that no one else has. Because there are thousands of people out there with the same degree that you are about to have in just a few moments. When you start that new job, if that's your next thing in your life, there will be thousands of people that have the same job and will be doing what you do for a living. The same is true for me, and the same is true for each of us here. But you are the only person alive who has custody of your life, your particular life, not just your life at a desk or your life on the bus or in the car or at the computer, not just the life of your mind, but the life of your heart, not just your bank account, but your soul. You know, people don't talk about the soul much anymore. It's so much easier to write a resume than it is to craft a spirit. But a resume is cold comfort on a winter night, or when you're sad or broke or lonely, or when you've gotten back the x-ray and it doesn't look so good, or when the doctor writes prognosis poor on your chart. So I wanted to share with you my resume very briefly. This is not what my professional bio says. You know, some of that's in the book and all of that. This is as proud as I am of all of that, but more the resume of just a bit about who I am. I think I'm a pretty good dad to 6 children. I have tried never to let my work or my profession stand in the way of being a good parent. And that is a struggle, but it's a very important struggle. I no longer consider myself the center of the universe. My children assured me of that. I show up, and I listen, and I try to laugh. I'm a good friend to my wife. She's sitting over here on the front row. I'm not going to look at her right now, though. I might not get through this. I've tried very hard to make my marriage vows mean what they say. So I show up, and I listen, and I try to laugh. I'm a good friend to my friends, and they to me. Without them, I would probably have nothing of interest to say to anyone. I'd be more like a cardboard cutout. I call them on the phone, meet them for lunch. I show up, I listen, and I try to laugh. I would be rotten, or maybe at the best mediocre at my job, if these other things were not true. You cannot be really first rate at your work if your work is all you are. So I guess the best piece of advice I could give anyone is pretty simple. Get a life. Get a real life, not a manic pursuit of the next promotion, a bigger paycheck, or a larger house. Turn off your cell phone or your BlackBerry or your iPad. Be still. Be present. Get a life in which you are not alone. Find people you love and who love you. And remember that love is not leisure. Love is hard work. Each time I look at my diplomas that hang in my office, they don't remind me of the accomplishments of those academic pursuits. They cause me to remember that I am still a student, still learning every day how to be human. Send an email, write a letter, kiss a child, hug a friend, do things that make life real. Get a life in which you are generous. Realize that life is glorious and you have no business taking it for granted. Care so deeply about its goodness that you want to spread it around. All of us want to do well, but if you don't do good too, doing well is not enough. And life is short too. Remember that. You know, in my life's resume, I was reminded directly of life's mortality. For instance, back in 1991, when I was taking my shifts at my wife's father's bedside when he was dying of cancer in our home. I was reminded again of life's mortality in 1996 when I lost both my dad and my brother within 3 months of each other, both taken far too soon by the ravages of disease. But I learned this from those experiences. Knowledge of our own mortality is one of the gifts that God gives us. It's so easy to waste our lives, our days, our hours, our minutes. It's so easy to exist instead of truly live. Unless you know there's a clock ticking. In our hustle and bustle, we often forget how wonderful life really is. Not life in cosmic terms, that's not what I'm talking about, but in small component parts. Raindrops, daffodils, the feeling of one of my children sitting in my lap, the way my wife looks at me. Life is made up of moments, and our goal should be to have as many of those moments as possible. We have to teach ourselves how to make room for those moments, to love them and to live, really live. Learn to be happy. Remember that life in this place is short, because if you do, you will live it with joy and passion as it ought to be lived. You know, any one of you can learn all of these things. Out there is the world, out beyond these walls. You just need to get a life, a real life, a full life. A professional life, yes. We hope that Sol Ross has trained you well to go and be very successful. But another life, too, because school never ends. The classroom is everywhere around you, and the exam comes at the end. No man ever said on his deathbed, or woman, I wish I'd spent more time at the office. You know, I've been blessed with an amazing life. I'm very thankful for that. You know, I was speaking to a group of colleagues not long ago with a similar message to this, and I confessed to them on that particular morning that I was sleep deprived that day because I had spent the night before walking and holding a 5-week-old foster baby that we had in our home at that time who could not sleep. A child that came into our home at 2 days of age because his mother considered drugs a more important part of her life than her baby. My wife and I were losing a lot of sleep at that time, but you can always find time later to catch up on your sleep. There is only one chance for a newborn to know the love and security of someone walking them and holding them late at night when they cannot sleep. For many years, foster care was the personal mission work of our family because it was a way we could use our gifts to help those less fortunate than us. The burdens are great, like all the lost sleep, but the rewards are greater. One final short story from Anna Quinlan's little book. She shares in that book that she met one of her best teachers on the boardwalk of Coney Island many years ago. It was December, and she was doing a story about how the homeless suffer in the winter months there in the New York City area. She met a homeless man, and they sat on the edge of the wooden boardwalk, dangling their feet over the side, and he told her about his schedule. Panhandling the boulevard because the summer crowds were gone from the island, sleeping in the church when the temperatures went below freezing, hiding from the police amid the tilt-a-whirl and the cyclone and some of the other seasonal rides. But he told her that most of the time he just stayed right there, on the boardwalk, facing the water, just the way they were sitting then. Even when it got cold and he had to wear the newspapers after he read them. So she asked him why. Why didn't he just go to one of the shelters? Why didn't he check himself into the hospital for detox? He just stared out at the ocean and said, "Look at the view, young lady. Look at the view." And so Anna concludes in her little book, "So every day, in some little way, I try to do what he said. I try to look at the view, and that's all. Words of wisdom from a man without a dime in his pocket, no place to go and nowhere to be. Look at the view. And when I do what he said, I'm never disappointed." In closing this morning, I'd like to share my favorite quote with you, a challenge in the words of John Wesley. I keep these words actually framed in my office in plain view. I've also shared these words with my students in the past as they were about to graduate and go out of this thing we call the real world. John Wesley's words are this: "Do all the good you can by all the means you can, in all the ways you can, in all the places you can, at all the times you can, to all the people you can, for as long as you can." I thank you very much for this opportunity to be with you this morning, and my sincere wish for all of you is that 2015 will be the very best year ever for you personally, and may God bless each and every one of you. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Kibler. In appreciation of your graduation address, I want to present you with this small gift.
Small? Thank you very much. Ride for the brand.
Sol Ross State University is very proud to recognize 15 undergraduates who are graduating with distinction, cum laude, magna cum laude, and summa cum laude. These graduates will receive a gold cord that symbolizes academic excellence. The grade point average required for the various levels of distinction appear on page 11 of your program. We are now ready to proceed with the conferring of degrees. Will the candidates for master's degrees please rise and remain standing as your degree is called? Master of Agriculture. Master of Arts. Master of Business Administration. Master of Education. Master of Science. President Kibler, the deans and I certify that each candidate presented on the official graduation list has completed all the requirements for the appropriate degree and that that degree may be conferred.
Based on the recommendation of the faculty, the provost, and by the authority vested in me as the president of Sol Ross State University by the Board of Regents of the Texas State University System, I hereby confer upon each of you and those graduating in absentia the appropriate graduate degree with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. Congratulations, graduates, and welcome to the community of scholars.
At this time, master's graduates may move their tassels from right to left. You may be seated. Will the candidates for bachelor's and associate's degrees and certificates please rise and remain standing as your degree or certificate is called? Bachelor of Arts. Bachelor of Business Administration, Bachelor of Fine Arts, Bachelor of Science, and one more, Certificate and License Vocational Nursing. President Kibler, the deans and I certify that each of these candidates has completed all graduation requirements.
Based on the recommendation of the faculty, the provost, and by the authority vested in me as the president of Sul Ross State University by the Board of Regents of the Texas State University System, I hereby confer upon each of you and those graduating in absentia the appropriate degree and all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. Congratulations, college graduates.
At this time, the graduates may move their tassels from right to left. Please be seated. Graduates receiving a master's degree will receive a hood representing the attainment of that degree. Assisting with the hoods will be the dean of the appropriate school. For the School of Agricultural and Natural Resource Sciences, the dean is Robert Kanukin. For the School of Arts and Sciences, the dean is Dr. Jim Case. Representing the School of Professional Studies, Larry Guerrero. Dr. Kilber will now present an honorary degree to a distinguished alumnus.
You know, this is a very historic occasion, and I am so pleased that all of you are here to be a part of this and to witness this. Sul Ross State University is about to award its first honorary doctoral degree ever in the history of this university. And we are going to award that degree to a woman who has epitomized the value of a Sul Ross degree. You know, Sul Ross was founded nearly 100 years ago as a normal school, a school that was created primarily for the purpose in its beginning to train teachers to work out here in the far west regions of Texas. The state found it difficult to get teachers to come here and teach. And so this university was created to train and provide those teachers. Ms. Helen Stewart Estes represents those people because she graduated from Sul Ross State University in 1940 and spent more than 60 years out here in West Texas teaching in the schools and teaching the pupils of West Texas. So she represents more than anyone else the true soul and spirit of Sul Ross State University. So it's very fitting and appropriate that she would receive the very first ever honorary doctorate from Sul Ross State University. She was raised in Midland, traveled to Sul Ross to complete her Bachelor of Education degree in 1940. And along with her exceptional career in teaching, earlier this year, she celebrated her 100th birthday. Join me again in congratulating Ms. Helen Stewart Estes, Dr. Helen Stewart Estes.
This is what makes Sol Ross a special place, as the graduates and alumni of Sol Ross University know. We will now present the graduating class of the fall of 2014. Could the marshals please assist the graduates? A designated area has been roped off for family representatives who wish to take pictures of the graduate. Please make your way to this area a minute or two prior to the reading of your student's name. This area is right on my right, to your left if you're in the audience. Ushers will be on hand to assist you. Everyone else should remain seated throughout the diploma presentation. Out of respect for the solemn nature of this ceremony and for audience safety, no air horns are allowed in the building. Thank you. After diploma tubes are handed out, Mr. Butch Worley will present each graduate with the Bar SR Bar pin from the alumni office.
College of Agricultural and Natural Resource Sciences, Master of Agriculture, Kelsey Rob Kabbalah, Animal Science. Diane C. Trevino, Range and Wildlife Management. James Cameron Martin, Range and Wildlife Management. Rebecca Lynn Nogler, Animal Science. Bachelor of Science, Lenora M. Blanchard, Natural Resource Management. Desiree Hope Brewster, Animal Science, cum laude. John Clayton Kiddo Campbell, Natural Resource Management, cum laude. Matthew Lawson Dunnigan, Natural Resource Management. Maddie Ann Dunshee, Animal Science, summa cum laude. Jose Luis Etchert, Jr., Animal Science, magna cum laude. Amanda A. Gonzalez, Animal Science. Juan Ramon Hernandez Jr., Natural Resource Management. Eric Knudsen Shepherd, Natural Resource Management. College of Arts and Sciences, Master of Arts in Public Administration, also graduating with a Master of Science in Criminal Justice, Juan F. Campos. Master of Arts in Public Administration, and a Master of Science in Criminal Justice, Vanessa Chavez. Master of Arts, Leah Katrina Farnsworth, Public Administration. Master of Arts, Martha G. May, Liberal Arts.
Today we want to commend Marty May for completing this degree. It's been a 7-year process, and she's overcome numerous obstacles as well as health issues. But just several weeks ago, she did complete and submit her final thesis project for the Master of Arts, Liberal Arts. Please join me in congratulating her.
Master of Arts, Justin Travis Rustrum, History. Master of Arts in Public Administration and a Master of Science in Criminal Justice, George Spencer. Master of Arts, Karina F. Sturgeon, English. Master of Arts in Public Administration and a Master of Science in Criminal Justice, John E. Surface. Bachelor of Arts, Bianca Cristal Barrera, Spanish. Teresa Nicole Bernard, Psychology. Casey Marie Campa, Music. Cum laude. Lucia Hernandez Carrasco, Communication. Jennifer K. Easley, General Studies, Cum laude. Thomas Anthony Garcia, General Studies. Amber Elizabeth Lynch, General Studies. Bethany Ann Gaylor, Psychology. Cum laude. Travis Miles Granger, History. Xavier Dion Jefferson, Psychology. David Ferdinand Keeney, History. Juliana Ray Larinaga, English. Denise Marie Mercado, Political Science. Edward Joseph Ochoa, Jr., Social Science. Holly Angelica Sawyer, Psychology. Erlinda Soto, Spanish. Aida Veronica Wong, Spanish. Bachelor of Science. Cassandra Hope Aguilar, Mathematics. Michaela Beth Bowlesby, Biology. Lauren Elizabeth Crouch, Biology. Okay. Julie Gutierrez, Biology. Alexandria Hassenflew, Biology. Crystal Hyman, Biology. Abraham Fofana Kamara, Geology. Alexandria T. Lee, Environmental Studies, cum laude. Sabina Marie Lozano, Biology. Marty R. Marine, Geology. Caitlin Mache Moody, Biology. Shannon Nay, Biology. Genesis Reyes, Biology. Charles Michael Sansom, Biology, magna cum laude. College of Professional Studies, Master of Business Administration, Ufuwamwa Anidi, Business Administration. Jeriel Calvo Quitoriano, Business Administration. Cristina Lorena Ramos Ponce, Business Administration. Laura Guadalupe Rodriguez Villa, Business Administration. Melissa Varela, Business Administration. Sarah A. Amin, General Education. Erica Maria Armendariz, Educational Leadership. Cheryl Barclay, Counselor Education. Gina Denise Browning, General Masters. Josephine M. Castillo, Educational Diagnostician. Brian Allen Castleberry, General Masters. Shannon Deanne Dean, Counselor Education. Carmen Renee Drinkard, Educational Leadership. Susan M. Frost, Educational Diagnostician. Vanessa Alessandra Galvan, General Masters. Luis Carlos Garcia, Educational Leadership. Justin Jacob Gonzalez, Educational Leadership. Marcia Yvonne Harrell, Educational Leadership. Diana Hakes, Educational Diagnostician. Travis A. Gerald, Educational Diagnostician. Carmelita Ann Jimenez, General Education. Stephen R. Kurtzrock, Educational Leadership. Christopher Scott Kirkendall, Educational Leadership. Edith Loya, Educational Diagnostician. Joe Alexis Martinez, Educational Leadership. Carla Ochoa, Educational Leadership. Christine Dolores Payares, Reading Specialist. Alma Delia Porras, Counselor Education. Eva Quesada, Educational Leadership. Naomi M. Rivera, Counselor Education. Priscilla N. Rodriguez, Counselor Education. Tony Marie Sands, Counselor Education. Shiloh Marie Sugart, Educational Diagnostician. Julie Ann Tolliver, Counselor Education. Veronica Tovar, Counselor Education. Amanda Cepeda Urias, Counselor Education. John Scott Wasserman, General Masters. Bethany Jo Whitfield, Educational Diagnostician. Christina Maria Whitman, Counselor Education. Master of Science, Michael Durand, Criminal Justice. Kenneth Wayne Hughes, Criminal Justice. John David Ortega Jr., Criminal Justice. Monica Sandoval, Criminal Justice. Bachelor of Applied Science, Sarah Hidalgo Cook, Organizational Leadership. Cristal Lynn Garcia, Interdisciplinary Studies, magna cum laude. Guillermo Garcia Jr., Interdisciplinary Studies. Susana Olguin, Interdisciplinary Studies. Mihaku Nishizawa Rodriguez, Interdisciplinary Studies. Rosario Arranza Ramos, Administrative Systems and Business Technology. Beatriz Elena Wong, Administrative Systems and Business Technology. Bachelor of Business Administration, Danetta Dawn Kinsey, Business Administration. Alfonso Rodriguez Leal, Business Administration. Bachelor of Science, Azriel Alnitra Evelina Anderson, Kinesiology. Christopher A. Avalos, Kinesiology. Ashley Marie Carney, Kinesiology. Lee Edward Fitzgerald Carruthers II, Kinesiology. Stephanie Ann Carranza, Kinesiology. Trevor John Doyle, Kinesiology. Tess Brigida Gratzel, Criminal Justice. Growl. Audrey Lee Holmes, Interdisciplinary Studies, magna cum laude. Cody Ryan LaCroix, Kinesiology. Jessica Lynette Lopez, Criminal Justice. Aaron Jacob Macias, Criminal Justice. Myra Lynn Mason, Criminal Justice. Turner Robert Mattson, Kinesiology. Isaac B. Pathick, Criminal Justice. Justin Soria, Criminal Justice. Timothy Studebaker Stewart, Criminal Justice. Casey Valenzuela, Interdisciplinary Studies. Megan V. Burley with a certificate in licensed vocational nursing. Alicia Dawn Holmes, licensed vocational nursing. Corey Lee Kohlhoff, licensed vocational nursing. Adriana Valles Munoz, licensed vocational nursing. Jade Spear, licensed vocational nursing.
Please join me in thanking our reader for this morning's ceremony, Professor of the Year, Dr. Joey Velasco. And let's have another round of applause for all our new graduates. As new graduates, you now are also our newest Sol Ross State University alumni, joining thousands of other Sol Ross alums around the world. Now, would all our graduates stand? Would all the faculty who have had a hand in teaching our graduates please stand if you're not already standing? There may be a few people here today that have helped support our graduates over the years. Would the parents of our graduates stand if you're not already standing? Maybe some grandparents have also provided a bit of support. If you're not standing, would you please stand? There also might be spouses and children, siblings, aunts and uncles, and friends who have lent their support. Would you please stand? Perhaps anyone who is not standing and able to stand this morning wandered into the wrong building. But even so, I invite everyone else who is able to stand to join with Dr. Donald Freed to sing our alma mater. The words are printed on the back of your program. Thank you, Don. Please be seated. To honor our graduates, everyone is invited to a reception on the mezzanine in the back of this building immediately following the recessional. But for now, remain seated until the recession has ended. Will the marshals prepare for the recessional?